Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Easy Home Cooking. Today we're gonna show you the easiest way of making the chicken dum biryani. This particular recipe is made by my mom, and actually I was the one who first learned how to make it, and this is the easiest version that my mom is showing, which she learned from me. So do try it and enjoy. This is really very easy, so just look at the recipe and try it once. You will definitely enjoy, and so let's get into the recipe. So all the ingredients will be mentioned in the description below, but I'm gonna tell it in the voiceover too. So let's get into the recipe. This is a 1/2 kg chicken that my mom has taken. Now let's add in the ingredients. 1 spoon of turmeric powder and 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste, 1 tablespoon of garam masala paste that is my mom's recipe, and I'll put the description, I mean this link in the description where you can prepare the masala paste. Then add in some red chili powder, and these are all dry masala ingredients. Cinnamon stick, star anise, jawitri, that is mace, then a few cloves and cardamom, and the bay leaf, and 1/2 cup of curd, along with 1 tablespoon of salt and a little bit of oil. This is 2 tablespoons of oil. Mix all the ingredients and keep it aside, marinate it for 3 to 4 hours. The more you marinate, the tastier the biryani would be. So you can even marinate for 2 hours minimum, but the more you marinate, the tastier the dish would be. This is how you should mix everything. Check for the salt if you can, and add in if you need it. Then cover and place it aside. Now soak in some basmati rice for 1/2 hour. That's 2 cups my mom has taken. For after the 1/2 hour is done, put some water to the boil. Take a lot of water, not exact amount, but more than needed. Add in some salt and shahi jeera. The salt is like 2 tablespoons. You can add in more if you need it. Check for the salt before you add in the soaked rice. Once the water comes to roll boil, strain all the water and then add in the rice. So once all the rice is added, and mix it up only once. Don't keep on mixing it, otherwise the rice would break into pieces. And let the water come to a boil again. Now you see they're cooking very nicely and the water is boiling a lot. Check for the rice, and it should be like 50 to 60% done. You can even cook for 70% too. That would also go well. So strain all the water, drain all the water, and add it to the marinated chicken. Just how my mom is showing. Spread it out evenly. Don't press it, just spread it out. And then add in some fried onions. These are made at home, not the store-bought ones. Just slice the onions and fry it in the oil until they are this color, like brown in color. After that, add in some mint leaves and coriander leaves. These mint leaves are from are homegrown at my mom's place in a pot. So add those and add in some coriander leaves too. And then this is a 1/2 cup of very hot milk in which some saffron strands are added. Once all the color is color gets into the milk, add it to the dish. After this, and in some cooked and drained water. The rice that we cooked, the water that we drained from the rice that we cooked, add in half cup of water. Because this is Indian chicken, not too much of water oozes out. But if you are cooking in US, you don't have to add that water. Once everything is added, add in the gasket and to the lid and keep the lid on a high flame. Cook for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, add in the weight to the cooker and then turn the flame onto very very low and cook it for 10 minutes. You won't get any whistle sounds because you're turning the flame to very very low. So after 10 minutes you can check there would be no gas in it. Open and check for the dish. This is how it will look once everything is done. You can see it's everything is cooked properly and even the rice is like pearls. They look like pearls and they're not sticking to each other. So now we can dish it out and serve it with raita and salan of your choice, but we like it only with the raita. If you need, you can add in lemon wedges too. So do try it at home and let us know how it turned out for you in the comment section. And one more thing, if you want to add in 2 tablespoons of ghee before you cover and cook the biryani. So please do try it and please subscribe to our channel, like and share our videos. Thanks for watching again. Bye bye.